I welcome you to this lesson. I'm teacher Katimbo Richard, as usual, teaching mathematics. Today I've come with the second episode of this algebraic summary in this class, primary 6, course term 3. And the advantage of watching this lesson is that you will be able to answer all the activities between pages 124 all the way to 126 of our book, term 3. So I urge you to follow as you will benefit in that regard. We are then looking at first example, which example reads, solve for x, such that 5x divided by 4 equals 5. Should be noted that this 5x out of 4 is the same as 5x divided by 4. So the operation that's mainly brought today is the division. 5x divided by 4 equals that 5. As you remember, we said to solve the algebraic equation, look at the operation brought and do the opposite. So the opposite of the brought division is the multiplication. So we shall then do the reverse, or the divide by 4, that is the times 4, to either side. Thus, first write 5x out of 4 equals 5, so that the LCM is 4. Remember, this 5 is out of 1, so therefore the LCM is 4, the denominator is 4 and 1, which is a 4. And we've got two sides, or two parties. This is a party, this is a sign. This is a party for which we are going to multiply, by which we are going to multiply this 4. We say 4 times 5x out of 4 equals 4 times that 5. And now, cancel this side, please don't go beyond the equal sign. So do divide. So cancel by 4. 4 divided by 4 once, 4 divided by 4 once, thereby remaining 1 times 5x, which is 5x, which is called a product of 4 and 5 is 20. So 5x share the 20 equally. So let's share then. We'll divide that side by 5, so I get x value. That is 5x divided by 5 equals 20 divided by 5, and cancel very well by 5. 20 divided by 5 get a 4, so that the x value is a 4, and that is it about this very number. So x is equal to 4. So when you come across a number like this from today onwards, please work it out in that way. As we look at the second example today, say simplify. Part A says 2n squared times 3n index 4. 2n squared times 3n index 4. Now, you must note that 2n means 2 times n, and n squared means n times n. Likewise, 3n means 3 times n, and n index 4 means n times n times n times n. In short, write those n's 4 times. This is what you have in expansion. 2n squared gives rise to 2 times n times n. Then 3n index 4 gives rise to 3 times n times n times n times n. And now, we've got 2 and 3, which look alike, as n's also look alike. So let's put these together for easy multiplication. Now we do put 2 and 3 together, so 2 times 3, then the n's alone, times n times n times n times n times n times n. Much as like terms or unlike terms can also produce a single answer when multiplied. It's better to bring the 2 and 3 together, then the n's separately multiplied, so that when 2 is multiplied by 3, you get 6. Then n times n times n times n times n times n. You need to count them only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That means the 6th index, or the 6th power of n. So the answer is 6, n index 6. That's 6 n to power 6, 6 n exponent 6, depending on your wish. So the answer is 6 n index 6, and nothing else. So this has been multiplication. Let's see how one can simplify the one that contains a division. Simplify 6m index 6 divided by 3m index 2. Let's see how we can simplify the division. It should be noted that 6m index 6 divided by 3m index 2 is the same as 6m index 6 out of 3m index 2. So I'm saying it's the same as 6m index 6 out of 3m squared. So if it means the same as this, then we can expand like we did up by multiplying by m repeatedly. So go 6 times m ensure the m's as mean as 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 then divided by 3 times m these are 2 and then effect your cancellations now m by m once by m once just one pair gone cancel pairs and the pair by m once remaining that whatever I see remaining. So I've got 6 divided by 3 once and 6 divided by 3 get a 2. So I've got 2m index 1 index 2 index 3 index 4. So the answer is 2m index 4. 2m to power 4, 2m exponent 4. So there are three kinds or three ways one can read that answer. And now we have simplified the division. So when you come across a number like that, please, from day onwards, don't hesitate to use that kind of style to work it out. As we look at example number 3, say solve for k. This time we have solving an equation which involves indices or powers. 3 index k plus 1 equals 27. 3 index k plus 1 equals 27. So now, remember this is an index, not 3k. It is 3 index k plus 1. Therefore, being that k plus 1 is a power of 3, we also express this 27 as a power of 3. You write 27 divided by 3, you get a 9. 9 divided by 3, you get a 3. 3 divided by 3 is a 1. So when you reach 1, then you have fully factorized that 27. Therefore, see how many 3s have come out. 1, 2, 3. So 3 index 1, 3 index 2, 3 index 3 reflects the 27. So 27 equals 3 cubed or 3 index 3. Now where 27 is, replace it with the power of 3. So that these two look alike, both must be bearing powers of 3. So that you read 3 index k plus 1 equals 3 index 3. And now here we are subjecting this equation to comparison. So we compare. So the down numbers called the bases are 3 each. This is the 3, this is the 3. Now is 3 equal to 3? That's the downer. We are comparing the downers. Is it that 3 is equal to 3? Yes. If these downers are equal, that's the basis, then so are the powers. So if 3 is equal to 3, then k plus 1 is equal to 3 also up there. So if the powers, sorry, the basis are equal, so are the powers. So go, 3 is equal to 3? Yes, then k plus 1 is equal to 3, but we are interested with the powers where k is and the 1 anyway we are asking for. So you are saying find the value of k, so leave the down ones. Now just take where k is the powers. So we go, that is k plus 1 is equal to 3. So k plus 1 is equal to 3, then solve that P4, 3 algebra. Say k plus 1 minus 1 equals 3 minus 1. See, 1 minus 1 is 0, so then k side equals the difference there, which is the 2. So the k value is only and only 2. And that's how we work out. In short, you first express 27 in the powers of 3, like you see, 27 has given rise to 3 cubed. Forget the 27 and write 3 cubed. And here you compare the down numbers and the later, the upper numbers. If 3 is got 3, leave it. Then they'll go the upper one is k plus 1 is equal to 3. And if that is done, I don't have a doubt that you will do everything. As we look at example number 4. Example number 4 reads, solve the inequality. Inequality, so here we talk about inequality, meaning these are unequal things. Whenever you see greater and less, there will be inequalities. Whereas these are called equations, while they are being equated, for them they are equal. These are inequalities, the opposite of equations. So like 5 will never be equal to 6. It is ever be unequal. So 5 is less than 6. For 11, 6 is greater than 5. So those are inequalities. So an equation, or something that looks like an equation, where we have n of these signs, that is less than or greater than, as you know, we don't call it an equation, but an inequality. So this is an equation where it has been equated, it has got the equal sign, and this is an inequality because of a less than symbol. So read the inequality first. 2b minus 4 is less than or equal to that 0. 2b minus 4 is less than or equal to 0. In solving an inequality, we remember the idea of solving equations. So we solve like it is an equation, but not forgetting that here we don't have the equal sign like it is here. So solely this sign that is maintained, we work out as though this is equals, but never involve the equals. So we've got to solve now. 2b minus 4 plus 4 is less than or equal to 0 plus 4. And remember, in the same algebra we said, minus 4 plus 4 is the same as plus 4 minus 4. So to understand it better, you interchange. You start with a plus. That's 2b plus 4 minus 4 is less than or equal to that sum, which is a 4. Where 4 minus 4 is a 0, so it's gone. Remember, 2b here is less than or equal to 4. Now, as usual, we divide the other side by 2. That's 2b divided by 2 is less than or equal to 4 divided by 2. Whereby 2 ones, 2b by 2, you get a b. 2 by 2 ones and 4 divided by 2 is a 2. So that the answer is b is less than or equal to 2. All in all, ensure you don't change this inequality sign to an equal sign. It's not an equation, it is an inequality or an inequality, depending on the way you pronounce it, but it is an inequality. So b is less than or equal to 2, and that is the answer to that question that tells us to solve the inequality. As we look at example number 4, for it is going to be in word form, the one you call a word problem. So let's then read. Jane is twice as old as Sarah. Jane is twice as old as Sarah. Then if their total age is 45 years, how old is each of them? So they want everyone's age. We've got two people here, Jane and Sarah, and one is younger than the other. Now, ask yourself, who is the younger of the two? The fact being that Jane is twice as old as Sarah, then Sarah's age is half. Jane's is half. Jane's. So Sarah is the younger of the two. We normally suggest the younger's age. That's why we chose to suggest Sarah's age, for she is the younger of these two. We go, let Sarah's age be k, such that when Sarah is k years, Then J is twice K, that twice as old as the other one, means twice K, two times that one. So two times K, you get 2K. Yeah, so J is 2K years old. And now we are saying, if the number N is 45 years, the word total is respected by addition. So add their ages in terms of K, 45. That's why you say K plus 2K equals 45. Now, when you add here, you get 3K, which has got 45. You go 3K divided by 3, it's got 45 divided by 3. You cancel by 3 once, 3K by 3, get K. By 3 once, 4 divided by 3 is 1 remainder 1. See how I divide, I say 4 divided by 3, 1 remainder 1. The remainder is taken to the next number here to be divided as a 5. So that 1 put together with 5. You get 15 now. 15 divided by 3 get 5. So then you have divided 45 by 3 and got that 15 times. So K equals 15. So that's the value of K. The unknown is described to be 15. It's now known. But the question reads, how old is each of them? They're asking for every individual's age here between these two people, Sarah and Jane. So that's why put one as a title, that is Sarah's age. It's K years, which K is got as 15. Now it's 15 years old. So Sarah is 15 years old. Then Jane's age. Jane's age. Jane is 2K years, which 2K means 2 times K. Now years, where K is 15, 2 times 15. That's the substitution of K. So I get 2 times 15 years, therefore Jane is 30 years old. And now, if you want to prove that your answers are correct, do add to see whether the total makes that 45-year kind of total. So that is 15 plus 30. R and C, is it 45? Then if it is, then no one will come and lie to you that you failed this number. So 15 plus 30 is that 45. And they are saying Jane is twice as old as Sarah. Is 30 twice 15? Okay, if so, then even that statement rhymes with the answer. So that is how you prove as we look at the last example. That's number 6, so in one form, which you must read and never should you fear to read and interpret. Amelia is 3 years younger than Amina. Amelia is 3 years younger than Amina. If their total age is 15 years, how old is Amina? So much as they're asking for Amina, you must know who is the younger. We normally suggest the younger. Amelia is 3 years younger. They have already told us the younger is that Amelia. Amelia is 3 years younger than Amina, meaning Amina is 3 years older than Amelia. So now propose the younger, or suggest the younger's age. You say, let Amelia's age be N, such that when Amelia is N years, then Amina is 3 years older. So therefore Amina is N plus 3, not 3N, it's not 3 times, she's 3 years older, more, so that is 3 plus, sorry, N plus 3 years. Okay, then they say if your total age is 15 years, still total up in terms of N, that's N plus 3, it's equal to 15. That is the equation of algebra called an algebraic equation that's been formed for us to work out. So we go now, n plus n is 2n plus 3 equals 15. So this P for 3, third term algebra. So we go 2n plus 3 minus 3 is equal to 15 minus 3, where 3 minus 3 is a 0, we've got 2n here. 2n is equal to 12, then we divide that side by 2. Here it is, 2n divided by 2 equals that 12 divided by 2. Cancel by 2 ones, by 2 get n. By 2 ones, 12 divided by 2 is 6. So that the unknown is now known as 6. That's any value 6. Remember the question asks for Amina's age. How old is Amina? Now you say Amina's age, go. Well formed your algebraic equation against Amina, that is n plus 3, which n is now 6 now. 6 plus 3, you get 9 years. So Amina is 9 years old. As you look at part B, the question reads, how old will Amelia be in 2 years' time? First, know Amelia's age now before you know her age that time, the 2-year time. So Amelia's age now is 10 years, and now that Amelia is 6 years old then. So Amelia's age in 2 years' time. So you know future calls for addition. So if you're asking for 2 years ago, then that would call for subtraction. So Amelia's age will have increased by 2 from now. And now that this Amelia is 6 years old, then after 2 years to come, this Amelia will be 6 plus 2. Her age will have increased by 2 years, and now she will be 8 years old then. So that's how we answer the questions. Otherwise, when algebra is known, it becomes very interesting. And when known, I don't have any doubt that you will have to pass mathematics. So that is episode number 2 of the algebraic summary. And now you can answer any question regarding to that at that level of RP6, P6, primary 6, that is R plus term 3. I am teacher Katimbo. Richard has taught you that. And if you need to reach me in terms of any clarity, please don't hesitate to reach me on these 2 numbers. The first one is MTN line, which is 0775251655. You can as well use the Airtel line 0757233066. Beyond that, I have nothing to teach you. That marks the end, that is, of this lesson. Please stay safe and bye-bye.